Hey guys, coming to you from my backyard here, and a couple of you have been really after me to get this guitar done, so I powered through last night and got it all buttoned up. There's a few things I want to tweak yet, but we'll go ahead and take a look at it, and then after we look at it, I'll play it a little bit too. So, as you can see, since the last time you've seen it, I stained the box, and that's a walnut stain on there. And you see I used that kitchen cabinet hinge for the tailpiece, and it's all strung up and everything. And then I've got basically like a Gibson style jack plate there with the quarter inch jack. And then if we can see that, I made a little piece of hardwood there underneath the tailpiece, and that's where the guitar strap holder goes, as you can tell. And that way it's got some good hardwood on the inside and the outside for that to go into, so it's good and sturdy. I've got a brass clasp here to hold the box shut, and of course you know about the strainer and the stainless steel bowl, and then I made a wooden biscuit out of red oak, and it's got a piece of threaded rod for a bridge, and that's working pretty well. I may experiment with a couple other things just to get the most acoustic sound out of it I can, but for right now it's working pretty well. And then you can see the little strainers there for sound holes. And you might notice there's a little switch in there. That's a mini switch. And that little toggle switch actually turns on a microphonic pickup that's inside the bowl. Okay. And then I can flip it and go just to the single coil here as well. And I may end up swapping that single coil out. That's just an old one I had laying around here. But I wanted to get it together. It works pretty well, actually. And you can see I stained the fretboard as well. And those are brass tacks for fret markers. And those work out really well too. And you can see the bolt for a nut there. And I did add like a Fender style string tree there for those two longer strings, just to keep them at the angle I want. But, and you can see how the neck came together. It's nice and smooth, and got that heel going into the box there. And over here, you've got the hinges for the box, obviously. And then this is the tone and volume control. And those are actually inset into a closet pull, a closet handle. And I thought that worked pretty good. And one of the more unique features is actually inside the box. So let's take a look at it here. And what we can do, give me a second here guys, I'll just lay it on its face like that and see if you can just open this up like a typical box. And I've got these tabs in here that hold it pretty snug even when it's not latched. But anyway, when you get inside, you can see that I've stained that neck piece there. I think that turned out pretty nice. And then my wiring here, I used some little brass hold downs, like brass picture hangers is what those are, and they hold my wiring where I want it. And I ran it down here because I didn't want it to show through those holes of the strainer, so that's why they're where they're at. And then the last thing in here is on the lid, I actually painted Robert Johnson, who's considered the king of the Delta blues. And you might know the story of him selling his soul to the devil at the crossroads and all that. So I put him at the crossroads here, and I actually cut it off so I made it look like a cross as well. And then he's sitting on a tree stump and playing his old guitar with the thumb pick and everything. Hopefully you guys can see that. It's so glossy because I polyurethaned it, so it's a little hard to get it. But and then it says Rambling On My Mind, because obviously my channel is Rambling Around, but also he has a really good song called Rambling On My Mind, so I thought that was fitting. And then down below him, I just painted his name so people would know, you know, anybody that wasn't familiar would know who he is. And then of course I signed it just like any other painting, so. But, you know, I think it's a unique instrument for sure. And hopefully you guys like it. I'm gonna go inside and get out the amp and play it a little bit for you so you can see what it sounds like. I've still got some things to tweak with the bridge and everything to make it sound better acoustically, but I thought I'd go ahead and plug it into the amp here and just show you at least what it sounds like electrically. And then as I make some changes, I'll make some more videos and show you how it's coming along. Anyway, I'm tuned to an open G, G, D, G, B, and we're just going to give it a shot. I'm just going to play around and we'll see what's up. Tweaks, I'll come back and show you the progress. So thanks again for watching this whole project, and I'm gonna have more of these guitar builds in the future for you. So thanks again, and I'll see you later. Bye.